Hello everyone, this is Dr. Leela. Today I'll be discussing on investment, importance of investment and types of investment. Please do subscribe my channel.
Investment. What is meant by an investment? Investment, it is an asset which is acquired with the goal of generating income.
Or you can define investment as an asset that has economic value and which is able to provide future benefit.
When we talk about future benefit, what is meant by future benefit here? Future benefit here is goal of generating income.
Or in simple words, you can define investment as long-term saving. Nature of investment. When it comes to the nature of investment, what is meant by it? It is the application of money for earning more and more money. And investment also means savings or savings made through delayed consumption. Investment, it is defined both in the economic and financial terms. Why? Because these are interrelated. When an individual saving flows into capital market as financial investment, which are further used as economic investment. That's the reason investment is both financial terms and economic terms are interrelated. When it comes to the definition of economic sense and finance sense, economic sense, it defines investment as purchase of goods that are not consumed today but are used in the future in order to create wealth. Whereas in the financial sense, investment, it is a monetary asset purchased with the idea that the asset will provide income in the future. And the objectives of investment are safety, growth, and income. Apart from that, there are some other objectives like liquidity, hedge against inflation, reducing the risk, tax exemption, etc. When it comes to the safety, what is meant by safety? Why we are talking about the safety? How investment is related to the safety? Safety in the sense, no investment is completely safe, but there are products that are preferred by the investors who are risk averse. For example, you can take fixed deposits, government bonds, etc. This and all, you can take it as example. When it comes to the growth, apart from safety, what investor want? Investor want to receive capital gains. That is, they want whatever the amount invested by them, they want that investment to grow. For example, stock, mutual funds, commodities, gold, real estate, etc. This and all, you can take it as example under the growth. When it comes to the income, some individuals invest with the objective of generating a second source of income. That is, whatever the investment they make, they see that offer returns regularly. And the factors to be considered by an investor for an investment are inflation, time value of money, fulfilling financial goals, financial securities, savings on taxes. When it comes to the factors, before we talk about the factors, let us talk about the importance of investment. Most of the individuals, what they aspire to have financially independent life. And we are living in a world where the world is surrounded by full of uncertainty. And not only that, here in the economy, we find three type of people. People who make things happen, people who watch things happen, people who wonder what happened. But to be successful, what you need to be a person, you need to be a person who makes things happen. And in the importance aspect, investment, it is the process of using capital to generate a safe and acceptable return over a period of time. When it comes to the investing, an investor should consider the factors, as already I said, that inflation, time value of money, fulfilling financial goals, financial securities, savings on taxes. Inflation. What is meant by an inflation? It is continuous rise in price by decreasing the purchasing power of a nation's currency. Or else you can define inflation as when prices of goods and services increases in an economy. Inflation, it is usually measured over a year period and it is always expressed in terms of percentage. What will be the goal of any investor? Goal of any investor is to increase their long-term purchasing power. But what happens, this inflation puts this goal at risk. Why? Because the returns from the investor should first match with the rate of the inflation. Why it need to match with the rate of inflation? In order to increase the purchasing power. This inflation, it poses a slight threat to the investor because it chips away the real returns of an investment. how to calculate the real returns. It is the difference between investment return and the inflation rate. For that, for better understanding, I give you an example. For example, if savings is 50,000 and the savings interest is 4%, interest inflation rate is 6% in the economy, and what is the real return? What is the amount of saving? Saving is 50,000. So for that, when you take 4% on that, it comes to 2,000. So what will be the total value of your savings? It is 52,000. So what is the inflation rate in the economy? It is 6%. So when you calculate 6% on 50,000, you are going to get 3,000. So what is the real returns? Real return formula is investment return minus inflation rate. So investment return, how much you got? 2,000. And the inflation rate, how much you got? It is 3,000. So what is your real returns? It is minus 1,000. That is, your returns are in negative. So what will be the total value of your savings at the end of the year? It is 49,000. So here, in order to beat the inflation, what the investor should do? Investor should invest in an investment option which gives him higher rate of return, leaving them surplus income. Why? Because the surplus income helps in meeting their financial goals. Time value of money. Time value of money is also known as discounting principle, and it is one of the most fundamental concepts in finance that money has time value. Time value of money, it states that money in hand today is worth more than the money expected to be received in future. In simple terms, you can define time value of money as rupee today is more worth than a rupee tomorrow. Time value of money is always dependent on the time interval and the rate of discount. Why? Because this is used in calculating the current and future values. And there are certain factors that determine the money as time value. And the factors are risk and uncertainty, inflation, consumption, investment opportunities. Risk, and first one we will see about risk and uncertainty. Why time value exists in risk and uncertainty? As we all know that future is never certain and we cannot determine the risk involved, especially in respect to the cash inflows, as they are uncontrollable. Inflation. When you talk about inflation, in an inflationary economy, a rupee today has always more purchasing power when we compare with the rupee sometime in the future. Consumption. Always what individual think, individual prefer to the current consumption to the future consumption. Investment opportunities. An investor can be profitable. When he can be profitable? When he uses money received today by investing it immediately. Therefore, time value of money is dependent on time interval, rate of the discount for calculating both current and future values. And not only that, time value allows investor to adjust the cash flows for the passage of time, and it is an integral part of the capital budgeting process, and it is applied both for the calculating present value and the future value. Third one is fulfilling financial goals. What is meant by financial goal? Financial goals are the series of financial events through a life cycle of an individual where he or she requires money for various activities. And what type of goals an individual has? Goals can be buying a house, children education, vacation, marriage, etc. When you talk about financial goals can be short term or long term. For that, what is required? Financial planning is required. Why financial planning is necessary? Because it helps in systematic approach towards achieving financial goals, and you can plan the investment accordingly. And the factors required to be considered or needed to be considered for attainment of financial goals are time horizon, savings, and risk tolerance. Time horizon. What is meant by time horizon? Every investor sets a time for the investment in order to achieve the objective over a period of time. And risk tolerance. Risk tolerance, this is also called as risk appetite, and this is the type of the risk an individual is willing to take. When we talk about the type of the investor can be risk averse and risk takers. Therefore, the risk bearing, it depends upon the type of the investors. And savings. Savings. What is meant by savings? Ideal resources is called as savings. It is the amount, or it is the amount saved for the financial goals. And what are the benefits for the financial planning? So we are talking about the financial planning, isn't it? Financial planning, what are the benefits of it? It increases the cash flow and it helps in attaining the future needs and attaining the financial goals, helps in tax saving, helps in wealth creation, and also for securing retirement. And there are few steps for the financial planning. The steps are identify the goals to be attained, analyze the existing investment for attainment of goal, to prepare financial plan, implement the financial plan, periodically review the plan. These are the general steps which are required for financial planning. And the first one, when we see the first one, identify the goals to be attained. Every individual has goal, isn't it? So here, accordingly, what the investor or individual should do, he has to plan investment to accomplish the goal. And the second one is analyze the existing investment for attainment of goal. Investor, what investor should do? Investor should analyze his investment for attainment of predetermined goal. And the analysis helps in identifying the shortfalls in the capital required. And the third one is prepare financial plan. In order to convert the goal into reality, what the investor should do? Investors should prepare a plan stating the time horizon and the return on the investment. The plan also helps to see different avenues from which he could earn maximum returns. And they implement the financial plan. In order to realize the dreams of an investor, he has to implement the plan by investing regularly and periodically and reviewing to earn maximum returns. And the last one is periodically review of plan. A review of plan is important. Why it is important? Because review helps in identifying whether the plan is going in right direction or not. If the plan is not going in right direction, it indicates that investment must be changed. Financial security. Financial security, it depends on how much you save and how efficiently you invest. Investment also helps in building corpus, which can be used in attaining financial goals and also to offset any future financial emergency. And the last one is savings on taxes. Savings on taxes, every income earned is taxable. It can be either in the form of direct taxes or indirect taxes. Not only that, investing helps in saving taxes. And government has provided various options for deductions and exemption under the income tax. And the maximum rate you find the tax can be levied is 30%. And the last topic of this is types of investment. We have various investment alternatives available to an Indian investor. Investment can be fixed income investment or market linked investment. The difference between these two is fixed income investment, the proportion of risk is very less and the returns also is less. Market linked investment, the proportion of risk is very high and returns are high. That is, risk is more, returns is high. When it comes to the fixed income investment, returns are less, risk proportion also is very less. The example you can take under fixed income investment are public provident fund, bank deposit, government securities, national pension schemes, bonds, debentures, this and all. You can take it as example under the fixed investment. And market linked investment, you can take example as real estate, equity, gold, commodity, forex, this and all. You can take it as example under market linked instruments. And lastly, I want to discuss about the guidelines to be followed while investing. You try to procure a written document or obtain a written document explaining the investment in detail. Read them carefully, understand the written document, verify it, find out the cost and other charges which are associated with the investment, evaluate the risk and return of the investment. Try to know the liquidity and the safety aspect. Check whether the investment is matching your specific goals or not. Compare your investment with other investment options that are available in the market. compare the investment which you have already made with other investment and try to deal only to the authorized intermediaries. Why? Because this is very safe for the investment. Before investing, seek all the clarifications about the intermediaries and the investment related doubts, and consider the investment option which is available to you. See whether they match your requirement or not. That is, whether they match your specific goals or not. Thank you.